Have you ever seen those adorable pictures of dogs posing in a kissing booth or a lemonade stand? Those cute photos required a specific trick frequently called two paws up. Two paws up is where your dog poses with his front feet on a platform and his back feet on the ground. Not only is this skill great for pictures, it's also a base trick for a lot of other useful commands. Two paws up can be used as the first step in teaching hind end awareness. And it's also the first step in teaching your dog to use a scratch pad for the rear legs. To train this trick, you will need a stable platform big enough for your dog to stand on, treats, and a clicker. Start by luring your dog onto the platform and clicking to mark the correct behavior. This is Leia, and she's never done two paws up before. She has a bold personality and has no problems being lured. This is Sandy. She's also never done two paws up. She's a little bit shyer. Notice how she hesitates before stepping up. That's okay, every dog is different. Both my new dogs stepped up on the first try, but if yours won't, mark the closest your pet will come to it. This might be just looking at or sniffing the platform, or it might be just one paw. Once your dog is regularly interacting with the platform, start rewarding only the efforts that are closer to the end goal. For example, if your dog will touch the platform 5 times out of 10, only reward touches of the platform. Once your dog will put both paws on the platform, the next step is to name the command. Pair luring your dog onto the platform with the word of your choice. I use up. Pair the command with luring at least 10 times a session for several sessions, then test your dog. Say up, but don't lure. Will your dog go up? Great. If not, keep pairing the lure and the command until your dog will. You may have to fade the lure, for example by pointing, but not having a treat in your hand. Finally, you'll want to expand the amount of time your dog is in the correct position. You can start by asking your dog for up, but delaying the reward a split second. Don't reward if your dog breaks early. Gradually expand the time your pup is up there until he can do it 5 to 6 seconds. Once your dog knows that waiting is a possibility, a break command is the best way to help him stay reliably. A break command lets your dog know they can stop performing a command. This helps your dog understand he has to wait until you tell him to stop. Otherwise, they'll be constantly looking for cues they can stop, and any motion will cause them to break their command. That's how you get this. And up. Stay. Stay. Stay.
She's walking away. My treats are leaving! She moved! Pace up!
To teach a break command, ask your pup for two paws up. Wait a few seconds, but within the time frame your dog tolerates. And then toss a treat while giving them a verbal release. I use break. Do not reward leaving the platform if it's done before the break command. You want your dog to learn that the verbal cue is a signal they can stop. Anything after this is proofing the command. Proofing is important to make the commands more reliable, but is endless in scope. For this video, we're assuming you'll want to be able to take a step back for a picture, or have your dog stand on the stool long enough to work a scratchboard. To make the command more reliable, try asking for two paws up while you are in different positions, such as sitting or standing. Try asking for two paws up and taking a step back. At first, even tiny motions may cause your dog to break the command. Practicing in different places, different positions, and with different movement will help your dog understand they need to stay until released. Yes, even if you step back slightly. Once your dog can readily get up on the platform on command, get down from the platform on command, and stay even with small movements for a short period of time, it's safe to start using this as a base for other tricks.